you to this this hangout. What we're going to do is very quickly and very swiftly go through the compensation plan, the rewards program here with INFINii. So we've got the experts online to go through that. We got the architects of the compensation plan, and they're going to go ahead and show you guys exactly what this compensation plan is all about, how you can benefit from it, and how you can really kind of why it's the best compensation plan out there in the industry. I don't have to be bold saying that because from our standpoint, it's the truth. You're going to see it, and if you've ever seen any comp plans, you're going to pick that up very quickly. But this is the best thing out there as far as the rewards programs in the industry. So I want to turn this over. We want to just get this moving. I want to turn it over to John or Ken and get them to start rolling into this. John, Ken, would you like me to turn it over?
Sure. Ken, why don't you start talking while I pull the deck up? So
my pleasure. The guys, I tell you, after going through, and I'm sure all of you were part of the hangout we did last night, and going through really understanding what the platform is that has been put in place for INFINii, it gives you the idea and should have given you a full understanding that this is rock solid and it's been thought and planned out across the board. I think part of that large planning you'll see goes into the rewards plan. Myself and Nitesh and the other members of the team that you see here, John and Kevin, we spent a lot of time going through and really creating something here that I think you'll be quite blown away with at the end. So, John, you got it up? You ready?
Yeah, I'm not sure if is it up right now, Kevin?
No, not on my end, John.
No, click on that green button on the top left.
Sure. Me and technology are like brother, like we're brothers.
It's there now. When you click on it, you'll have a choice of different things to, it'll come up with a second screen, John. It'll give you a choice of which screen you want to share. And yeah. I can see that. Okay. So it looks like you're ready.
Okay. I'm good to go.
Eric's not up yet, John. There
you're
go.
Seeing the whole screen, right?
Yep, got it.
Right on. Okay. Okay, well, welcome, everyone. Thank you very much. Thanks very much, Kevin. Listen, before we dive right into this, because once we get into it, we don't want to break our momentum because we're going to go through this in a pretty quick order. Was there something that is there something that, Hitesh, you want to discuss what we're going to talk about with Springboard with us right now? Do you want to do that? Or would you like us to do it exclusively? You want to do us to do that right now at the beginning to clarify a couple of things?
Oh, no, I think we can do that during the presentation itself. It would make a lot more sense. I think the only thing I would emphasize at this moment before we go into this is it is a little bit more unique than what you might have seen, but it's unique in the sense that we spend a lot of time simplifying things that usually are kind of complicated in typical MLM comp plans. And sometimes they're complicated because they're trying to hide the fact that you're really typically just making 30 to 50% at most. 30% is more close to the norm of what companies actually pay out. So in our case, it was more a matter of making it very transparent, making it very easy for you to understand and see that we're actually paying out very consistently about 70%, all the way through. And the big thing you want to keep in mind here is as you go through this, that there are two very unique structures. They're all based on what's called business volume, that's BV, in this entire presentation. And you're going to generate BV in many different ways. So there are two questions that you really constantly want to be asking yourself as you go through this. One is, how do I generate BV? How does my organization generate BV? And the second question is, what is the optimum way for me to design my organization? How should I pursue it, and how should I create an organization that is going to be profitable with the BV being generated? So just ask yourself those two questions during this entire presentation, and we, as usual, encourage you strongly to ask questions relevant to that towards the end.
Absolutely. Okay, thank you very much, Hitesh. So we will make sure that we deal with those particular issues when the control dock is up and we start showing the distribution of business volume and how it accumulates from the various pieces of this. So, Ken, why don't you get started sharing the basic concept behind the dual team, especially using the terminology accelerated, and then we'll get into the unit level.
Sure, John. When we start to really take a look at what's on the screen right now, you know, I've been designing compensation plans for the last 10 years, and whether it's a stair-step breakaway model, a matrix, a straight-up binary, or unilevel, or ultimately a hybrid of the two, which is what we did here, that was kind of the discussion that the team had. We wanted to put together the most aggressive rewards plan for the INFINii family. And at the same time, you know, with combining those two, you know, kind of fastest growing aspect of a dual team or a binary plan with the tried and true long-term residual unilevel, the idea is to bring that binary unilevel hybrid together. And by bringing that together, it allows people to really win in a big way. And of course, if we look over the last 10, 15 years, the largest owner or incomers by far in the industry have come from binary unilevel hybrids. But we took it one step further. Because when you look at the general design of the team structure, on the left side you'll see the dual team, or what we refer to as the binary, with two teams or two legs. And on the right side you'll see the unilevel design, which is where your personal enrollment tree is comprised of. By bringing these two together, we were able to explode it, but we added in one particular piece where we took the negative away from the binary. And as those of you who have been in the industry for a long time know, binaries are awesome, but you can also end up in a situation where the binary can actually completely impede or restrict your ability to rank advance. So, you know, for example, if we were dealing with, like many binaries are out there, the vast majority, 99% of them, all of your rank advancement and your income is going to be based upon your lesser leg. So right off the bat, you're kind of put at a disadvantage by the majority, and as Hitesh was pointing out before, the design breakage components within a compensation plan structure. So if you had a million in volume on your right leg and you had 100,000 on your left, then you've brought the company 1,100,000 in revenue, which is doing great for the company and for your upline, but you're only going to be really paid on that 100,000 because it's going to completely rank restrict you, so you're not going to be able to advance, because most compensation plans will require either the number of cycles or amount of income you've earned at the end of the month or week to determine that. But what we did, we took that factor away. We created what's called an accelerated binary, where only the first two or three ranks within the starting phase of the rank structure require an even build. And then from there, it completely releases the lesser leg requirements. So even if the circumstance occurred where you had a million on the right leg and you had 20,000 on the left leg, then as long as your personal enrollment tree was taken care of on your power leg with all of the requirements for the rank advancement, you could literally still hit the highest rank in the INFINii compensation plan, even though you only have literally 20,000 on your lesser leg. So that means that your unilevel or your personal enrollment tree is the key to rank advancement. And we'll go into that further, John, as we go through.
You bet. And, you know, the thing is that's interesting about this particular plan, Ken, especially because of the INFINii pay bonus that came out of Hitesh's brain to really amp up the post-binary bonuses that we're starting to see in so many plans. Because that INFINii pay bonus is so huge, the fact that what you've just discussed, being able to rank advance all the way through to the very end of the compensation plan, even if your binary income is less than impressive, I'll tell you that that INFINii pay bonus is truly remarkable. So let's just take a few minutes and talk about how business volume accrues, and maybe this will be a great spot for us to pull in that other point too. One of the things that all of you are going to absolutely grow to love about INFINii is about really such a massively diverse range and significant range of places where business volume can accrue up either the left or the right hand side of your dual team, and also of course into your INFINii pay bonuses. So you can see a very basic example. Pam starting her young team of Sue and Mark. First and most obvious is they're using one of our platforms. Sue's using Surge at 150 business volume. Mark's using 400. In addition to that though, and of course that's no different than what you would be used to, in addition to that, though, as Sue starts to use that platform the way it's meant to be used and starts generating additional business volume from everything she sells on Amazon or eBay, you're going to benefit from that. Just like when the marketplace becomes available to you and you start seeing some incredible deals that are in that marketplace. In fact, Mark might not only have bought an item from the marketplace that generated business volume for you, but he may turn around and go and sell that on Amazon or eBay and generate even more volume for you. Anything you want to add to that, Ken?
No, John, it's straightforward. The beauty of this model, though, is that in most companies, again, you're really dealing with either just the initial enrollment that's creating business volume into the organization or the rewards plan, and or the monthly renewal or auto ship of orders. But within the INFINii platform, you're seeing business volume come in from multiple different funnel points, which is going to cause people to see just a massive increase on the amount of business volume that would normally come in from any single person or organization. So you're going to see it rapidly amped up within the dynamics of how much business volume is going to be produced by each end user.
Absolutely. And not only that, some of you may be familiar, may have built compensation plans where your enrollment package, $500, $1,000, $1,500, the BV attached to that is going into your dual team, and your monthly reorders of the same product are going into your Unilevel. That can be a devastatingly unconstructive strategy, because as happens in any business, in any industry, not just network marketing, business goes through peaks and valleys, and occasionally business flatlines. And what's going to happen to your business volume, your dual team volume, if it only comes from new growth and your business is going through a temporary or worse, a permanent stall, you're going to absolutely destroy your binary volume. So that's not going to happen here. We don't split the volume up this way. And this, again, is one of the perks on your end, benefiting from as much as this plan pays. All of this volume is not only is it going to your dual team, but a very specific dedicated amount of all of this volume is going into your Unilevel as well. So we'll just quickly have a look at some of the ways that this starts to accumulate it. And many of these points you heard Hitesh speaking to yesterday. So platform fees, other activities, e-commerce, marketplace, digital products and services, vendor supply. We didn't talk a lot about vendors. We're going to get more into vendor information for you as those things become released. Needless to say, though, each one of these represents a very, very significant amount of traffic in your business volume. And then when you see what we're going to do to help you attract customers, it's going to add a whole new layer of a huge influx of business volume into your business.
Hitesh, would you mind coming in here and talking, because there is some confusion with the members around the springboard and how BV is actually generated through that. Would you take a moment to address that?
Absolutely. It's actually ridiculously straightforward, and this is one of the unfortunate situations where this industry as a whole, and I don't know if you want to call it industry or if it's just human nature and so on, that people want to think of it as something really complicated. And it's hard for them to understand how it functions and how simple it is. And unfortunately, many companies in the past have used things like this or used ideas like this to build something very unethical and do really horrible things to people. So let me walk you guys through how Springboard works, and it'll all make sense. So in this case, let's say Sue comes in and Sue says, hey, I want to start selling on Amazon. I want to start selling on eBay. We already saw from Ken's case study, for example, that there's a ramp-up period. It's going to take her a little bit of time to really make that her primary business right out of the gate. So she says, listen, I don't want to do the hard work of contacting China and dealing with suppliers and negotiating deals and bringing it into the U.S. and storing it in a warehouse and then shipping it to Amazon. Okay. So what we said is, look, let's handle that work for you. We will do that hard work for you, and we will start helping sell this item on Amazon for you. So Sue comes in, and now instead of negotiating with China, she looks at the product listings that we provide her with, a whole selection of different products. She says, oh, I like these products. I look at the market, and it looks like these products will sell on Amazon really well. She then takes those products, looks at the price margin on them. She sees that in Springboard, the product is available for $20. It's selling on Amazon for $45. She says, this looks like a pretty decent profit margin. Let me work out what my exact price, the actual profit would be on the sale. So she calculates it out. She says 45 is what it sold for, 20 is what I paid for it. I'm going to have to pay some Amazon fees in this process, right? Amazon is going to charge her some fees. Those fees are going to work out to somewhere in the neighborhood of $12 to $30 in some cases. In some cases, maybe $9. So we'll say $12 to be on the safe side. So now she has a $13 profit margin. And then we have additional fees on it. For us to actually bring it in and store it in a warehouse and then ship it out, there are some costs there. And that's what our management fee is. It's very straightforward. It's very transparent. And it's upfront. So she looks at all of that and says, all right, so it looks like that if I take this product and I ship it to Amazon, if it sells on Amazon, I'm going to make a $10 profit per sale. With Springboard, she literally has this work really, really, really made simple for her because she doesn't have to go to China. She purchases the product at manufacturer prices. She doesn't need a warehouse. We do all of that work for her. And now the product gets sent into Amazon and it starts selling. Every single time the product sells on Amazon, it generates a profit for Stu, and it also generates certain amount of BV in the system. The BV is our fee. Okay, so our fee is 2%, which we convert into BV. So every time this product sells for $45 on Amazon, it's going to generate 0.9 BVs. Almost 1 BV in the system will be generated each time that product sells on Amazon. That's one of the strongest parts about Springboard. The only way it generates BV and the only way any of this generates BV is when there is real customer retail activity happening in the entire system. That's one of the big missing pieces, right, from pretty much every other company, why this is such a strong system. So let's walk through the numbers really quick. Imagine that Sue ends up selling over the course of the year. She ends up selling 1,000 of these water bottles or whatever it is that she sells on Amazon through Springboard. In that case, it's going to generate nearly 900 BV in the system, which Pam will see in her genealogy. She's going to look down her genealogy. She's going to have generated a 900 BV extra compared to what you would ever get in any other company from use of Springboard. I want to clarify a couple of points right now. One, when Sue buys the $20 product from Springboard, it does not generate any BV, just like it won't generate any BV when Sue buys it from a manufacturer in China or a manufacturer locally. Sue also doesn't get any BV. No BV is generated in the system when Sue just lists the product. Because guess what? Lots of people list products and they try their hand at business and it doesn't work out. The BV is generated when the product actually sells on Amazon or sells on eBay or whatever platform is being used to make the sale. So what is the benefit to Sue? It's very straightforward. She gets to basically take a shortcut through her business, just like Amazon FBA offers a shortcut for you. So you don't have to ship the product yourself. You don't have to get the customer yourself. You don't even have to do as much customer service yourself. Just like that is a shortcut. Springboard is a shortcut for you on finding the product, listing the product, and getting the product into Amazon. So Sue now has a shorter pathway to getting to profitability. If she's an international person in this case, she might not have an Amazon account. She gets to leverage our expertise and our Amazon accounts, just like Amazon FBA. If you don't have a warehouse, you send your product to Amazon and you leverage Amazon's warehousing. The same way with us, if you don't have your accounts, if you don't have a presence online, you leverage our presence online and use that to generate sales. Every single time the product from Springboard sells on Amazon or eBay, it generates 2% of the price in BV. So if it's a $200 product that sells, it's going to generate 4 BV. If it's a $500 that sells, it's going to generate 10 BV, and so on and so forth. Again, you really, really need to understand the true potential here, because we are talking about millions and millions and millions of dollars in sales happening all the time that's generating BV for you at virtually no effort, because it's all coming from real end consumer activity. When the end consumer purchases the product, it generates BV for you. And that's what makes this such a stable system, that you're not dependent on just BV generated from within your teams. So you have a great incentive to build this. Your customers have a great incentive to use the Springboard. We have a great incentive because we make a profit using our management fees in there, which is a very, very minor piece of it, actually. We don't actually make very big money on it. And then finally, you have Amazon making money by selling the product. You have the end consumer being happy because they're purchasing the product that they wanted, and Amazon is giving it to them in 2 days using Prime shipping. So everybody's happy. This is how e-commerce is actually supposed to work. This is how the free market is supposed to work, and that's how it generates BV for you. So
you know what? You know what else is
pretty clear.
Oh, sorry, Tash. Well, the other thing I was just going to say that's very, very noteworthy, for those of us who come from a traditional product network marketing company, we're really talking about the purchase of a product, in this case, Springboard products you're buying via your Prime membership or your Surge membership or your Excel membership. The only way that I would be able to generate a profit in my past experience is if I took all those products in the health industry or in the skincare industry or whatever it happened to be and managed to sell those for a profit, which would certainly not be a significant profit and a very significant amount of work for me to do that. So the contrast between the two scenarios is really night and day.
It's true. And John,
I'm sorry, Ken. There's one very important point I wanted to make here, which you mentioned this yesterday regarding the FTC and VEMA. You know, the core issue there is purchase of products for self-qualification, affiliates buying stuff so they can be qualified to be in the comp plan. You will not find any of that happening here at all. The comp plan by design doesn't function like that. And Springboard is a great example of it. Your customers, your downline, when they're purchasing products from Springboard, they're purchasing products because they want to participate in e-commerce and they see that they might be able to generate an income using it. That's why they're using it. They're not buying it to try and hoard it and put these products in their garage, hoping that they will make enough money through recruitment. Totally different business models.
Trying to talk their accountant into letting them write it off because it's a cost of doing business.
Yeah, it is a cost of doing business.
Well, Hitesh, I would say that probably what the average person that's been in network marketing, or the average network marketer, I should say, that's been in over the last 10 years, they might be used to, or maybe 2 years, they're looking at going, okay, I need to build X size of a team, and then they try and figure out what their income could be off of the auto ships and everything else like that. So, you know, where they look and say, okay, hey, if I could build a team of 1,000 people, then I could make X. Well, the entire multiplier has changed dynamically here, where it's not so much dependent upon the size of the team. It's dependent upon the individuals within your team and the e-commerce that's taking place. So what ends up happening is you could make 2, 3, 4, 5 times more with a team that's half the size in a normal than you would find a normal network marketing company because of all the e-commerce movement and the real business to end user customer sale that's taking place here.
Yeah, there, and we know there are some leaders that are listening that are really getting this stuff now, and some leaders that this is very new to them and it's taking a little bit of time to sink in. If that's the case, don't feel bad because that is the group that I would be in. I've had the luxury of being around these models and being able to speak to these guys on an ongoing basis for a long time now. But I'll tell you, when you understand this, the fullness of this, you're going to be extremely excited because this is a very different situation than what you're used to, aligning with a company that manufactures one type of product and you only earn when that one type of product is sold. That's not the world that you're in anymore.
Yeah. And I'm going to just make one final point, and I do want to move to other parts of this comp plan because there's some very exciting stuff that we haven't touched upon yet. But I want to make one very important point here. In every company that you've worked with so far, if you're a professional network marketer, if you've built other network marketing businesses before, if you have done that, every single time, the only way that your growth your team's growth is really valuable to you is if those guys turn around and start recruiting as well. When a guy comes in and joins your company or a lady comes in, joins your team and is just a consumer of your product, you kind of treat them as less than because they are not going to help grow your business, right? You're only looking for the affiliates. You're only looking for the partners who are going to expand that business for you. This is where the dynamic is so different because you could have people come into INFINii in your downline. They just focus on their e-commerce business. They're just using Springboard to build things out. And they're producing thousands of business volume points for you. Thousands, literally thousands. We actually have people in the company right now who, if you just looked at just their e-commerce business, they're worth 4 to 10,000 points every month. Just that one individual. So this is no longer about how do we recruit people and then teach them to become recruiters, and then we have to worry about why we have such a high ratio of affiliates versus customers, right? I mean, that's what's going on with the FTC compliance issues and so on. You don't see that happening with us because your customers are worth a BD as well. Go ahead, John.
One other thing that I think is really important to share too, Hitesh, is as people start to understand just how many INFINii participants are going to be using the platforms, will be generating $100,000 in sales per month and more, when a portion of that is converted to business volume for you, that's an extra $1,000, $2,000. That's money that you're receiving in business volume and then ultimately profit through your Infinity Pay and through your dual team. That profit is not actually coming from the rewards plan. That business volume is being generated from outside profit and outside sales in a completely different world. So, you know, it's really quite exciting how many different funnels of real transactions to real customers that are really happy with their purchases are all going to be feeding this. Okay, so listen, the fast start bonus, everyone understands the fast start bonus is very simple. We're spending 6 seconds on this. 15%, one time only, of whichever platform your friends, your personally sponsored friends enroll with. $60 is obviously 15%, roughly of $399, and you would also generate 15% of the $50 for Prime or $150 for Surge. Now, the beginner bonus we can spend a little bit more time on for a couple of reasons. One is it's very unique. Many of you have probably never heard of a beginner bonus. And two, this beginner bonus is going to do an awful lot to pull your business forward. Ken, do you want to share the basics of this? Do you want me to?
Yeah, John, I tell you what, the beginner bonus is probably one of the most exciting things that we've put in here for that beginning user because, you know, we know the industry. We know that, you know, the statistics are out there that 90% of people never make any money. They get involved in with a company and maybe they purchase a $500 starter pack, they purchase $1,000, $1,500, some of them are over $2,000. They get all of these different products sent to their house, and then 30 days later, their first auto ship arrives, and you know, on average, they'll be either on 100 to 200 auto ship, and so all of a sudden, they start garage stacking up the products in the garage, and you know, the difference here is that number one, your membership level is giving you access to a platform that's immediately going to put you on the path of multiple things. But at the same time, if you'll just take the very simple step of introducing two people, and not just two partners, it could be two customers, it could be a customer and a partner, it could be two partners, you just introduce two people to this platform that come on at least at the Prime level, and what you're going to find here is that automatically you're then able to access this beginner bonus pool, and then based upon as you begin to build, based upon your first two or three ranks, you're going to be able to earn either $600 out of here, $1,200 or $1,800. And what's beautiful about this is we take 6% of the full 70% of the global business volume that's dedicated to the field. So 6% of that is taken to fund the beginner bonus pool. So you can imagine that's actually a lot of money that's going into this pool. And then based upon how many beginning individuals are participating in this, it's equally divided up. And once a month, they receive an amount out of the beginner bonus pool until such time as they've reached the maximum allowed. If they've continued to advance through the first couple ranks, which are nothing to advance through, as you'll see as we go through those, then they could actually earn all the way up to $1,800. This is a dramatic change because there in other companies, there wouldn't be any of this money being made at this point. And this is a way that people can stay in a very positive cash flow right out of the gate.
You know, one of the great things about this beginner bonus too, Ken, is that it really was designed for beginners. So yep. It's important that you understand, everyone understands this. For those individuals that we all know and we all love because they're very loyal to us, they're very loyal to their team, and they so desperately want to be successful in home business and for the life of them have never been able to. That individual can attract a couple. We know statistically they can manage that. If they did nothing more than that, the following month they would still be able to earn. And the following month after that, they would still be able to earn. Even if their team of two did nothing the following month. That's what this beginner bonus is designed to accomplish. So now it gives that rookie, that individual that really has, unfortunately, a black rain cloud walking over the business part of their life, it gives them that opportunity to now show that result to someone else who's never had a track record of success. And guess what? They're starting to build an effective team. If they taught one thing only, and that is for their two friends to become beginner bonus qualified so they also could benefit from this pool, that would be all they would need to start driving their business forward.
And then, John, so, at the same time, they're building their e-commerce business, which is an additional revenue stream outside of that. So it's just a win-win.
And they're participating in Springboard, absolutely. So I guess technically that's a win-win-win, Ken.
Great.
So listen, here's just a little bit of the basics behind, and we'll move on very quickly. There are caps to protect the beginner bonus, just like there are caps to protect the entire plan, which is one of the things you have to do if you're paying out as much as this plan is paying out. So there are one cap is based on activity points. You could consider that personal volume. So that's your platform amount plus any marketplace or eBay, Amazon activity that you generate personally. So that's one cap. You have the ability to earn 1.5 times that. And the example you see on the screen has 200 personal activity points. 1.5 times means you can earn a maximum of $300 for that month from the beginner bonus. Or the other cap is more of a group or team cap because it's PET based. So if your team that's growing is generating 400 business volume, 1.5 times 400 is a $600 for the month cap. Now, whichever of those two is lower is the one that's being used to cap your earnings at the beginner bonus. Again, because the beginner bonus is meant to be strictly for beginners and ultimately pay them out that $1,800, which we also know statistically is more than three times what the average beginner can successfully make in their network marketing efforts.
And John, one more point on that last thing. Since it's a pool, it's important to make clear to all the members that if we have an extremely large amount of members in this pool initially, it may not actually reach the threshold of the example you gave where it would pay them, let's say, $600 for the month or whatever, because if depending upon the pool and the level of disbursement, it could be lower.
Of course, that's a cap. That's a maximum.
Right.
That's right. Okay, so accelerated dual team bonus. Again, this is something that you're all very familiar with, dual implying two. You have a left side and a right side to your business. Now, this particular dual team is capped at $50,000 per week, a very, very healthy dual team these days. In addition to that, you can earn up to 20% on the lesser side of your dual team, and we'll get into that right now. So the first thing you'll notice is there are three families of ranks, the manager family, director, and ambassador family. And these are the up twos that I just mentioned, 10% in the manager family, 15%, and then 20% in the ambassador family. So we'll do a really quick blast through. First thing you notice, fam becomes what? Dual team qualified, or sorry, beginner bonus qualified. And then the first focus for her is helping Sue and Mark become beginner bonus qualified. Okay? So as this team starts to grow out, you can see accumulation of volume on the left side, on the right side of Pam's business. The lesser of those two sides is considered the pay side. That's 8,000 business volume. The manager of family ranks, 10% of 8,000 is an $800 paycheck. As this team continues to grow, and you notice that Pam has also personally sponsored Kim and Sam, so now she's got four personally sponsored individuals in her business. The lesser side of these two, you can see it's 28,000. In the director family of ranks, 15%. Gives Pam a weekly pay of $4,200, and as this really starts to build for her over time, then you can see now she's into the ambassador family ranks and is generating 20%.
Hey John, one of the important things on that is the majority of binaries, if you could click back 1 second, the majority of dual team or binary structures never pay more than 10%. So not only do we already have this set up as an accelerated dual team or accelerated binary structure, but you have the ability as you advance in rank to go all the way to 20%, which is double the normal for dual team structures. And any dual team structure... Yeah, exactly. And any of the other dual team structures that you see that pay, the 15 or 20%, usually they're just as John was talking about, where only new enrollment volume is being pushed through them, and then the auto-ships only go through the unilevel structure. But both the binary and the unilevel obviously are having BV pushed through them through both the new enrollments, the monthly renewals, as well as everything else. So you can see that the ability to really make a large sum from the dual team structure is very real, and it's not pie in the sky or smoke and mirrors like you see with so many binary structures or compensation plans out there.
So the INFINii Pay, obviously dual team is incredibly exciting, especially the way that it's been constructed here, especially now that you're starting to understand how much business volume is actually going to feed into your dual team. Equally impressive is this. And as Hitesh had mentioned earlier, Ken had some absolutely fantastic ideas because of his wealth of experience in rewards plans. And it was a real, it was a joy for me. Please excuse that. It was a real joy for me to be able to watch both Hitesh and Ken go back and forth on finding ways to just continually strengthen and simplify this offering so that it becomes easier and easier for individuals to understand and then ultimately really maximize this rewards plan. And this INFINii Pay is a byproduct of that. We've really taken, I think it was either two or three different rewards and compressed them into this, so that we have the ability to actually pay a unilevel plan on unlimited debt. And I think that that's probably a phrase that almost none of you have ever heard before, because I don't think that it has existed before. And if it has, it's probably in a very small, isolated case.
John, you know, you're so direct on target with that comment, because we all know some of the companies that have made a lot of noise over the last couple of years, and a number of them have 5% pay on each level, and they go down, you know, 6-9 levels deep, and only in your upper ranks do you capture an additional 1 or 2% to INFINii. With this being a true 5% to INFINii, kicking right in at the director level, which is one of our early ranks where this opens up, you know, it was exactly as you said. This was a mathematical algorithm formula that we had to sit down and go through time and time again before we sat there and said, okay, in order to do what Hitesh wanted to have happen here, and Kevin and Jason, with pushing the maximum amount into the INFINii Pay and making it available so that somebody, if they do a little bit of work, they get up to the director level, that they're going to be able to see that real money there. You know, it was a joy to go through the mathematical formulas to make this happen. And John, you're absolutely right. No other plan, especially a binary unilevel hybrid plan, would have a 5% to INFINii unilevel structure set in there. This is so far beyond an average unilevel or even a generational pay unilevel. To take this to an INFINii component across the board is a game changer.
It's pretty cool. It really is pretty cool. So now we all know what it's like to be the first to run the 4-minute mile. So it's pretty good. I'm really sweaty, but it was a lot of fun. And now I need to eat. So the basics right here of how this works. Obviously, you can see the Pam's business, first of all, is represented by the four people that she personally enrolled. And then they're starting, of course, in their unit level to enroll their personals and so on and so forth. And your business starts to grow. And now we've segmented things into the four personally sponsored partners that Pam brought in. So here are their names, and here is the volume that the organizations are generating, and this is what Pam's earning as a result per week. So you can see the entire organization's business volume and 5% of that total, and this is being added together for each of these personally sponsored individuals. Now, what's remarkable is what I was trying to say about this, is that for the month, this extrapolates out to just under $15,000 as an INFINii Pay bonus for the month. And Pam is she's in the middle of the director rank. That's a pretty serious income source that she's generated. More than that, check this out. As this really starts to grow, you can earn up to $200,000 on each personally sponsored line of lineage. Now, just to really blow your mind for a moment, There's many, of course, of the DSD members that are pursuing INFINii that are really skilled at cold marketing and funnel systems that I've met, I don't know how many people I've met that have sponsored 1,000 or 2,000 or 3,000 individuals into their business. It's really, it's quite bizarre coming from my world of warm market, traditional network marketing. But imagine how that affinity pay can get extrapolated over those kind of numbers if you are very team-focused and you help your friends, regardless of how many there are.
John, you there?
Bill, your thoughts, Ken?
Yeah, I lost you for a second.
I cut out, or you just want to understand?
Yeah, no, what I was... you cut out, but... No. You cut out. We lost you for a second. But it's, you know, when you look at this, John, you're, you know, when you talk about the ability to go ahead and build this level of income, you see a lot of rewards or compensation plans out there that say, okay, when you get to this level, then we'll start you on a new business center, and that business center goes above this one, and they play all these games, and then they say, in order to rank advance, you have to have X number. Like for example, you just said at the mid level here, at the executive director level, then she would, in many other plans, have to have, you know, two builders in each line of lineage, or a manager, or some other type of terminology that gets in there. So there's other kind of hurdles they have to clear. We've eliminated all of those hurdles in this rank structure, and even given them the ability to use up to 60% of the BV from any line of lineage, you know, towards the personal enrollment tree requirements in order to rank advance, where most plans start at best at 50 and very quickly accelerate down and have all the other requirements in there. So none of that exists with this, and you can make this income off of a single business center. So the other thing to stress here is with a lot of other companies, you'll see it going there, people own or will take positions with 1, 2, 3 business centers. Sometimes I've even seen builders take more than that. None of that is necessary with this.
And none of it's beneficial.
Exactly.
That's the amazing thing. This plan is so strong that if we made things any easier for you, we would go bankrupt.
And John, real quick, I just want to clarify that $200,000. I had some questions on that.
Sure.
People are asking if that's the life of that line of lineage. You want to break the good news to them? What that $200,000 cap is?
Sorry, you'd have to say that again.
The $200,000.
Yeah, they can earn that up to $200,000 per line of lineage per month.
Per month.
So that's the key here. And the other fact is that both the binary or dual team, as well as the Infinity Pay, which is the unit level, both of those pay weekly. And a lot of other companies, you'll see, you know, the binary pays every week, but the unit level pays once a month. And the other plans that you see the binary and the unit level paying weekly, they require you to attain the rank every single week. So you have to re-qualify at the rank every single week, and you can only use the business volume that week to qualify. Where we're actually only requiring you to qualify once a month, and in addition to that, you go ahead and get paid, though, every week on the binary and unit level. So it's an astronomical difference to most of the breakage models out there.
Huge. Yeah. Very significant. I've been teasing you with this slide, and then I keep coming back. And I'll show you again. And I know you're counting. How many zeros were on that slide? Zeros on this slide. Elevation bonuses truly are life-changing bonuses. Earn up to $10 million in cumulative bonuses. And you can see again from the arrow, this begins at the director family of ranks, 4 director family ranks, and all 4 ambassador family of ranks. So that brings us to this control page. Is there anything you want to say here, just getting rolling, how you want to roll this explanation out?
Yeah, you know, John, I believe what the members will appreciate most about this is if they go to the left, they'll very quickly see the 10, the 15, the 20%. So they'll have a clear understanding that relates to the dual team binary. And so this is a one-page simplified comp plan doc that you can go ahead and have sitting on your desk or share with somebody if they're experienced in the industry. If you're not experienced in the industry and this looks like Chinese or some other foreign language to you, don't worry about it. because everything is mapped out in a very simplified manner for you. But this is here for the people that want and have the experience to really look at it. So the next thing next to the ranks you see, directly to the right of that, you'll see activity, and then you'll see it where it says 50, 150, 400. Those are the monthly activity points. Now remember, you're not required to attain those activity points through your monthly memberships. That can be attained through the personal activity, the platform, the different things that both Hitesh and John were talking about previously. Now, next to that, you'll see the max PET, and that's in the top blue, and then going down, you'll see where it's 60% all the way to presidential director. You can use 60% of any one line of personal enrollment tree lineage towards your rank advancement requirements. Once you hit ambassador, it goes to 40%, and then ultimately crown ambassador and global ambassador is 30%. So what this is telling you is that you could go all the way to presidential director literally on just two enrollments, two people or teams that have gone ahead and built that up. Now, you could certainly have a lot more, but you could actually accomplish three-quarters of the compensation plan off of just two enrollment trees. And when you go to ambassador, go ahead, John.
I was just going to interject for 1 second because I get this a lot, and I understand why I get it a lot from people that this is very new to. The 60% they're asking, is that 60% of the business volume from someone in my PET? It's not. It's 60% of the 600,000. So 360,000 of the 600 you can get from one line of lineage. The other 240,000 can come from the other line or another 4, 5, 6, or 7 lines combined.
Great, great, great point, John. And let's take director because that's really where this opens up for your Infinity Pay, which is the Unilevel back end of this as well. So when you look at the requirement, and if we go from director, which is on the left, right next to the 15%, you move to the right, you'll see 150, 60%, and then you'll see the number 30,000. So that 30,000 is a monthly requirement from your personal enrollment tree. So you have 4 weeks of volume to hit that 30,000, and of that 30,000, since we'll take 60% of any one line of lineage, it means that up to 18,000 in business volume could come from any one personal enrollment tree towards that 30,000. Plus, another important point, and this comes into our accelerated binary at the same time, you see now that directly next to that, where it says 10,000, that's your lesser leg required volume. So if you look at that, there's really 40,000 in volume that's occurring there when you first glance at it, but that's not the case at all. When you look at it, it could be you could have 10,000 on your lesser leg, and you could have 20,000 on your other leg, and that would still represent the same 30,000 if it was all personal enrollment tree. But if you happen to have spillover that you were fortunate enough to receive from an upline member, that spillover, that 10,000, does not have to be personal enrollment tree volume. You just have to have the 30,000 in personal enrollment tree volume, but remember, the lesser leg does not have to be personal enrollment tree volume. It's a very, very important thing to understand on that.
And also, of course, the fact that, as you were alluding to earlier, that lesser leg requirement gets smaller and smaller and smaller the further into the rank family you get.
Yeah, it's an incredible thing when you look at what the volume requirements are. Look at any other company's plan, and you're going to see that you have to have those higher numbers are actually half the time lesser leg requirements and or overall requirements. And so on here, you can see that even if you're binary, which binaries by and large, one leg is always going to outperform the other. So inherent with the binary is that one leg becomes a strong leg and one leg becomes the lesser leg. So, you know, with this, we've taken away that negative. So if you have a balanced binary, awesome. You'll be able to really build out on the dual team and potentially get up to 50,000 a week. But if the binary just works out where you've got 90% of your builders on one leg and only 10% on the other, the great news is, unlike the other plans are going to block you, this plan is going to allow you still to go all the way to global ambassador as long as you meet the personal enrollment tree requirements that are necessary on your other strong leg.
Now, one of the questions that I know is coming up in a couple of slides, Ken, is about a little bit of confusion in regards to business volume and as it relates to Infinity Pay and the dual team. People asking how that business volume is split up, how you could possibly get paid on the dual team and still get business volume for Infinity Pay. Do you want to break down a little bit of the minutiae of the math there, or is it not necessary to do so?
You know, it really isn't necessary to go that deep into it, but what I would direct everybody to look at, John, is right where that big blue arrow is in the middle of the page where it says 5% to Infinity, directly to the right of that is the cap on each line of lineage at each rank. So, for example, at director, if you had 10 personally sponsored, then you could earn up to 200 on each one of those, or what would be $2,000 a week, you know, depending upon whatever level you have, number of personal enrollments. So all we're trying to do here is we wanted to give everybody the ability to make 5% to Infinity, but to recognize that we couldn't break the bank on one or two lines of lineage. We wanted to go ahead and let them make a great income, but at the same time, one of the protections is to have this. So when you begin to look as we go down in rank, you'll see that that continues to scale up on what you can make each week from each line of lineage, all the way up to $50,000 a week from each line of lineage, which is where the $200,000 per month cap on each line of lineage comes from, and that is capped at $50,000 a week or $200,000 a month at the global ambassador level. Now, John, you pointed out before that with a lot of the DSD members, they enrolled an enormous number of people. People that haven't really done the e-commerce side, just that are coming from network marketing, may have only enrolled 4, 8, or 10 people. And still with those limited number of enrollments, you can still unlock and see an incredible just influx of financial fulfillment through this plan, even at those numbers. But because of the Infinii model and your whole team moving into the e-commerce mode, people don't even realize the multitude of additional funds that are going to come in that, you know, a team, even a small team of 500 people, is going to result in.
Indeed, absolutely, well said. And I guess the last two columns we want to have a really, really quick look at before we move on is, of course, the Elevation Achievement Bonus, which is the $10 million accumulated. If you were to add up the final two columns, all of those numbers together, you would come up with the $10 million number. Now, this is, to say the least, this is a massive number, but what I think is even more exciting than the size of it is how achievable these bonuses are. I look at the director volume. If you divided that by the average authorship of $100, it's a team of 300 people. And the bonuses that it is unlocking are truly mind-blowing. Not only that, though, you're going to hit your first Elevation Achievement Bonus, which is $10,000. And if you do it in less than 90 days, and I know that many of you are going to, that's another $10,000 for you. So we're getting many questions as to how this is dispersed. The $10,000, then the $20,000, and the $50,000, and so on. If you look to the far right, you'll see in parentheses a number. So this is the number of months with which those payments are made to you. $10,000. We're not talking about the extra 10 bonus, but the $10,000 over 2 months. And when you move to that next rank, that senior director rank, these are cumulative in nature. 4 months to receive your $20,000, 12 months to receive your $50,000, and 18 to receive your $150,000, and so on and so forth. Now, as we get into the loyalty retirement, this is pretty funny. I know it wasn't meant to be funny, but for those very, very senior network marketers that are on this call that have had remarkable success and then really have lived the network marketing dream, you know, you and I and Ken, we know that we were just very lucky to be in that 1%, 0.75, 1.5. I'm not sure exactly what that number is, but we were very, very lucky to be in that group that made millions of dollars in network marketing. The vast, vast majority of people, it's their success isn't anywhere near that type of result. And so this really was meant to be this story that gets told about network marketing. Work hard for 3 to 5 years, and then you can kick back. This is really meant to be the actual physical manifestation of that. So this was something that Hitesh created, which I thought was absolutely amazing, and that is, as you get into these larger elevation achievement bonuses, you can see beginning at presidential director and then working all the way through the ambassador family of ranks, starting from $25,000 for 2 years, $40,000 for 5 years, $75,000 for 5 years, and so on and so forth. These are bonuses that you're going to collect after you've received all of the elevation earnings. So if we're talking about a Diamond Ambassador, once you've received all 36 payments totaling $500,000, then your loyalty retirement begins. And you will be able to collect that loyalty retirement whether you stay an active participant, an active spokesperson. Of course, you'll need to keep your platform payment paid, but you won't necessarily have to be investing the constant hours that you did to build your business to that Diamond Ambassador rank. If you decided you want to hang it up and go party on the beach, we're still going to send you that $75,000 a year over the next 5 years. So, and of course, whatever the rest of your business is continuing to pay you. So whether you choose to stay actively involved or not, those loyalty retirement is going to be something that you'll receive and can use to chill out or do whatever other goodness that you want to do in the world with that extra money. Anything else that you guys want to share on this particular page before we move on?
Yeah, I want to touch on this because, you know, everybody, if you've been involved in network marketing, again, we've said this, you'll hear me say this over and over again, typically a large, you know, a very successful network marketing career is nothing more than a lot of small network marketing careers, and there's something that you know, you should know about me and about Hitesh. I was in the United States Air Force. I retired, and because of that, I get a paycheck every month for the rest of my life, and medical and dental, right? Pretty good deal, pretty awesome deal. And imagine if that was applied to a network marketing company, okay? Imagine if a network marketing company, if an e-commerce company with a network marketing distribution channel, I should say, went out there and said, look, once you hit the rank of presidential director, we're going to give you a $150,000 bonus paid out over the course of 18 months. And after those 18 months of you getting paid out that $150,000, we're also going to say, if you lose your rank, if life happens, if something happens and you can't maintain the volume, we're still going to pay you $25,000 a year for the next 2 years. That's something that we haven't seen in the industry. And it's something, you know, that me being a military retiree, I can appreciate that, right? I can appreciate the fact that that exists. One other thing I want to note about this, I don't think we covered real quick, in the elevation ranks, most companies, if you were to hit an elevation rank, if you were to hit their bonus check, and they pay it out, let's say, over 18 months like we do on presidential director, if you miss it 1 month in another company, typically they keep that money. They hold it, right, if you don't make it. And then the next month, you make it. If you make it again, they let you have that money, but they always keep the money that you missed. We don't do that. If you don't make it consecutively,
they'll tell you that they have a party and they don't invite you, and that's how they spend that money.
That's what they do. They keep it for the company, you know. And I've experienced that. I've lived through that, where I've hit a rank and then dropped off on that rank the next month, and then made it again. But that month I dropped off, I lost $2,000 for that particular rank, and that happens over and over again in this industry. We don't do that here. If you hit the rank and you don't make it next month, guess what? It pauses it. When you make it again, that money's still there for you. And when you hit it 18 months in a row, for example, on presidential director, or 18 months non-consecutively, not in a row, could take you 2 years to do it. But if you hit those 18 months, after that's done, $25,000 for the next 2 years, even if life happens to you. That, to me, is huge for this compensation plan. So I'm going to hop off there and say that. And you guys carry on.
That was a very, very important point, so I appreciate that. Okay, last of the six, if you decide that you want to take a leadership role in this INFINii Rewards plan, especially working with INFINii, helping to share this vision, and you choose to stay at home to do it, fear not, because as INFINii enters various markets with some thunder and you start hearing through the threads inside the forums or on the Facebook groups, that there's huge success in various countries. If you cannot be there for some reason, you still have an opportunity to profit from that growth. And that's called a global bonus program. It's actually a little bit more than 4%. And again, this is paid out in the director family ranks and the ambassador family ranks. What I find really unique about this, though, is that you can see a little bit more than 4% is the total global pool, but you're accessing almost a full 50% of it at the smallest rank, at the earliest rank, at the director rank, which is really fantastic. And that's what's, you know, one of the things that's so difficult in constructing in compensation plans or rewards plans is something that is really balanced throughout, balanced from the beginner ranks to the intermediate ranks and to the high-level ranks, because we all know that not everyone is going to hit those high-level ranks. Not everyone's going to even hit those intermediate ranks. So are they all going to be rewarded effectively in a way that's exciting and people wanting to participate all the way through the plan? More than that, though, what's really unique about this is that the cost to get involved in this is something that, regardless of where you live, regardless of the strength of the economy where you are right now, you can afford to participate in this. And that was also very deliberate and something that we worked very, very hard on. So all of these micro details didn't just come together by accident. In fact, now I've just inflicted some pain on myself thinking about all the back and forth that happened for months and months putting this together. But I'm going to stop thinking about it because it's over now. We're finished. So let's dive into some of this stuff. Ken, do you want to tackle one or two of these or have a quick look and see if we've already done that?
John, I haven't read them yet, so let's see number one. How does BB relate to the dual team versus the unilevel? Does the same volume affect both of these bonuses? How is volume split up? Yeah, we already covered that one. Number two, please help me understand the beginner bonus and how it pays me. We already covered that. Is there a strategy that you would suggest using to build my INFINii business? My friends are confused when I share INFINii with them. Help me, please. John, you had a good take on how you were approaching that.
Yeah, we've got. Here's the thing that's important. I'd like to share with everybody. Obviously, we have some very, very, very skilled affiliate marketers that are involved in INFINii, and they are really all experts at putting together what we would call, network marketers would call, a cold marketing funnel system. And network marketers, you know, we're all taught since we were little babies and we still had soothers in our mouths that warm marketing first, cold marketing second. And there's obvious reasons for that. Cold marketing is difficult. And so if individuals that have a difficult time creating success in network marketing can't even penetrate their cold market, it's going to be a challenge for them to learn the skill set that, now, whether, I'm not saying that's correct, I'm just saying this is often what's perpetuated, often taught. It's certainly what was taught by me, because I specialized in teaching anybody and everybody how to penetrate their warm market without feeling weird or stupid, without bothering anybody, and creating great results for themselves. So the point is this. You are going to have opportunities to participate in some amazing funnel systems for cold markets, but we are also in the process of assembling equally a system, a very simple system for warm markets. So you're really going to have all the tools that I think that you're going to need to deal with this question specifically. We will have 2 and 3 minute company overviews that I think will generate a lot of enthusiasm and really help open that door for you.
Hey, John, on that point, I see Hitesh has rejoined us. So I love hearing him do the comparison on this that he does oftentimes. So Hitesh, I see you there. You know, are you free to come on?
I'm here. Actually, I was wondering if I could show you guys something quick that you might like. Give me just a second to pull it up. All right, so I just was able to get this image in time. This is actually from our warehouse today. We just had a pallet come in for Christmas stuff that we're going to be sending out. So this is actually one, like a third of our warehouse's side that you're able to see in this. But I just figured people want to see, yeah, there's a real warehouse with real products, with real stuff. These are examples of some of the products we're going to have up on Springboard. So you guys will be able to say, oh, these are some of the things that we are interested in, and we'll ship them off from here onto Amazon and save you guys all of the process along the way. So just wanted to go over that really quick. Now, what was the thing that you want me to compare?
It was to, how would you explain people that are having a difficult time, explain to their friends what INFINii is? So what would be the quick way that you could, in a 30-second elevator ride, give people an idea of what INFINii is?
Okay. Well, first of all, before you begin that, you have to understand your audience, right? Because you have very different audience, and your message has to actually resonate with the audience you're speaking to. So your audience is going to be the average person who's not a network marketer. Then you're going to have network marketers, and you're going to also have some people who are interested in maybe publishing their own products, or they're already doing e-commerce in some way. So you have three or four very different audience out there that you need to appeal to. So depending on what the audience is, your appeal is, your message should be slightly different. If it's a network marketer, it's such an easy thing to appeal with. We have a company where the average customer generates an income without recruitment, and it has the strongest compensation plan in history with over 70% in payout and a 1:1 ratio. That is enough to get any real person, any real network marketer's attention. They'll immediately pay attention to this. And if they don't, you probably don't even want that attention anyway. On the other hand, if you have the average person, a person who has no idea about any of the stuff, you actually begin with things that they do know about. They almost all know about Amazon and eBay and other companies like that. They all know about Google, Facebook, Amazon, eBay. Those are the four companies that everybody in the world more or less knows about. Okay? I don't know if this is a statistic that most people don't realize, but Google alone gets over 2.2 billion views every month. Okay? That's like a third of the world. It's kind of insane. So everybody knows these companies. So you begin with that. You actually say, we have a company. There's a platform that I use which helps me generate an income by selling products using Amazon, eBay, Google, and Facebook. That's it. That's your opening line, which establishes you as legitimate. It helps you, helps the other person understand you're working with these major platforms out there. The second line that you can use, or you can use at the same time, is I generate an income by selling products from one store onto eBay and Amazon, and I get to pocket the difference. It's a very simple concept, and it immediately begs the question of, oh, how do you exactly do that? How well are you doing with it, or what do you do with it? So again, for these things, you want to have your own case study. You want to have something that you've been doing. That's why Ken is such a great example for this. Can you imagine what happens when Ken meets other network marketers and he shows them his statistics from Amazon? Most of them already know that Ken is not the type of guy to sit down and build an Amazon business. So the fact that he's able to tell them, no, look, I actually worked with somebody from INFINii Projects who actually did this for me, I outsourced it, and I'm using a platform that automates all of these other pieces for me, it's very, very appealing to the type of audience that he's gonna speak with. So you have to first of all know your audience, and then you have to find the most recognizable component of your platform to share with them. In our case, the most recognizable component is the world of e-commerce. Amazon, eBay, Google, Facebook, all of these companies are in the news all the time, everybody knows about them. So use that a little bit to try and help them understand what you're really doing. On the other hand, if you're somebody who's just a content publisher or is just interested in online things in general, for them it's very straightforward. You say, we have a platform that allows you to generate an incredible income by selling physical products or by selling digital products that you can either publish, and even if you don't own them, you can still earn from them. And that's how you open the conversation. Now, I just want to give you guys one example. If I asked you right now, and I know there are some people in the audience right now going, well, but it doesn't explain Springboard. Well, you don't have to start out with Springboard, because Springboard is a little bit more complex. Most people who have never sold on Amazon or eBay won't even understand it. They won't even care how incredible it is until they understand that first, right? You're trying to solve a problem that in their head doesn't even exist. So that's not necessarily the best way to lead all the time. Of course, you should lead with that, with the right audience. But here's my point. If I asked you right now, describe Amazon to me. Describe the company named Amazon. You would struggle for a long time until you finally settle on the simplest way that would be most recognizable. And you would say something like, oh, it's a place where you can buy almost anything really cheap and they ship it to you for free in 2 days. That's kind of what you're going to say at the end of the day, because that's the most recognizable component of Amazon. In reality, Amazon doesn't really make any money doing that. They make their money from offering cloud services and show and streaming shows and all sorts of different stuff like that. But you don't go into those details. You start out with the most recognizable aspect, and that's what you really need to do here as well. INFINii is going to be such a massive ecosystem. You have to find out what part of this ecosystem is this guy going to be interested in, or this person that I'm speaking with is going to find that appealing. If you were speaking with somebody and they said, hey, tell me about the US. Okay, if you're speaking with somebody international and they said, tell me about the US, you're not going to be able to sit down and summarize all that is the US. You're going to choose one or two pieces of that that you really are going to focus on and drive home with it. So that's the way that I would go about it. That's the way that I find is the easiest to talk about it or to share about it. One of the great benefits you guys have is that you live in a world where you can make a 3-minute long video instead of a 30-second elevator pitch. You can make a 3-minute long video that touches upon these things and encourages them to get a hold of you for more details. And you can use platforms like YouTube, and you can use a lot of different strategies to get your message out there. You can use Facebook, you can use, it's incredible what you can do nowadays. So that would be the overall approach I would take. Something recognizable, identify your audience, and summarize and use the strongest points that will appeal to just that audience in a very short statement. That would be the way to do it.
Well, Hitesh, I think that's a pretty good way to compartmentalize. And the average person out there, as John was saying, we are going to be putting together things, and as Kevin pointed out, different funnel systems, and you're going to see a whole world of INFINii begin to open up with the website and all the other pieces in place. Hitesh, could you just as we wrap this up, because I know we've gone over the hour point, there is one question a lot of people have. Could you touch on the warehousing, the different points of warehousing that you've already begun to set up within the INFINii, and just how big this is? Because I know this is a comp plan overview. We're pretty much done with that. But I think as we wrap this up, and people listened last night to the vision that you had for INFINii, and now they just saw that warehouse for the first time, but that's obviously not the only infrastructure that has been created over the 2 years of planning for this. What else has taken place?
Yeah. Well, we actually have, we have some companies set up overseas already in multiple locations, which are going to be very instrumental in bringing products in and running a lot of other components of it. So that's already happened. In fact, we have a very impressive office being set up in another location. We'll be able to share this stuff with you guys over time. Before I continue, I want to just put a disclaimer out there. I have seen this stuff happen before, and I don't know if that was the intention maybe with this discussion as well, that companies will legitimize themselves by telling you they have a warehouse and they have an office and they have a location and stuff like that. And companies that are obvious scams will use that to sometimes legitimize themselves. So I want to first of all just put a straight up disclaimer about this. It literally doesn't matter how many branches we have and how many infrastructure pieces we have. Okay, we have plenty and we're going to talk about that. But that really doesn't matter. You have to stop and ask a simple question. Instead of just asking, can I believe these guys and does this sound really great? I really wanted to ask the question, does the concept make sense? Ask yourself this very straightforward question. Does the concept make sense that you can hold parties, invite your neighbors over, tell them they're overweight and sell them a shake, and you're going to make millions with that? Does that concept make sense to you? Because it never made sense to me. And that's why I stayed out of, in general, the typical MLM structures. Okay? It didn't make any sense to me. Does it make sense to you that every customer who you bring in or every person you bring in are worth exactly the same, and therefore you have to keep increasing the number of people in your organization to raise your income? That's not a sustainable model. Okay, that's not a concept that you can build a real business off of. In reality, every customer is worth a little bit different. There are people who are going to be producing a lot more than others. This is the only concept, this is the only model that I've ever seen where that's accounted for. You can have a customer generating 10,000 BV for you versus a customer generating 100. Okay, that's just going to happen because we allow you to grow vertically, and we also account for the fact that many times you have horizontal growth. Single individuals are sometimes worth very different amounts. So you need to keep that in mind. So before I get into the infrastructure side, does the actual concept make logical sense? Is this something that you can look at and say, oh, now I can see why an average customer can make money? Because if you don't see that, all the infrastructure should not impress you, and that should not be what you join the company for. That is not what you should promote the company for. It should be for the very simple concept of empowering the average person to build an income online by not recruiting, by instead participating in the real economy. You have to begin at that point. So now that we have said that, and that's clear in everybody's mind, so we have multiple warehousing structures in place. We're affiliated with one that is currently has been processing well into eight figures. I'd say actually last year was close to $40 million was processed through one warehousing facility, and we have, you know, pretty good stake there, and without going into too many details, we're able to leverage that very massively. We have one on the West Coast. We have one here down in Texas. Both of these are port locations, so it allows us to bring products in very quickly, allows us to process them quickly. We have one facility that's a true warehouse, while the other two places are more of what we call sorting facilities for Springboard. The idea is to bring a product in. It actually doesn't typically sit there with us for a very long time. We immediately turn around and send it on to Amazon, where it goes to their warehouses. Okay, so that's what sorting facilities do. Our offices that are overseas are there to provide a central location, I guess, in these other countries. At the same time, they also serve as offices for other pieces of INFINii. For example, INFINii projects has a team that works overseas already that basically functions as our core team of users. We have our chat support set out of there. We have our developer support set out of there. We have a lot of different things running out of there as well. On top of that, we have our own headquarter offices here in Cypress, Texas, you know, right outside of Houston. And in fact, one of our plans is to hold certain paid shopping events right here. We're going to have people come to this place. We're going to take you guys to our warehouse. We're going to go shopping. We're going to pack up all the stuff at the warehouse. We're going to ship it off to Amazon before you head back home. And then you can replicate that in your hometowns. Wherever you are in the US, you can actually replicate that there and start growing a team there and start growing your business there as well. So those are all the infrastructural assets we have. And obviously, as needed, we can grow even more. We don't foresee that we will need to grow a whole lot more than what we already have because of our business model, which is largely digital. And then when it comes to the physical products, we function more as the sorting system and the channel that allows you to streamline it instead of the company that's going to function just like Amazon. So that's kind of what it is. You know, it's pretty impressive. I kind of stand back sometimes and look at that and go, you know, this is kind of impressive. Not a lot of companies can say that this is what we have going for us, but that's what we have. It's kind of nice and it's great, but that should not be the selling point. The selling point needs to be your understanding of the very simple model that Sue can come in or Mark can come in. They can work with a very small team of people. They don't need to recruit 5,000 people in here. They work with a very small team of people. They list items on eBay and Amazon. They list items on their own stores. They use Springboard if they don't have access themselves, and they are able to grow their income from there. So that should be what you should be really focused on. I think we have tremendous numbers with that. It makes sense. It makes logical sense. The type of logical sense that I have never seen MLM companies make before, and I'm sorry for riffing on that too much, but they just don't. And I don't know why people pretend like they do. You have a business model where 99% of people are failing and everybody's acting like that's okay, and it's really not. So I kind of get a little bit, I don't know, I'm more puzzled about it than I'm annoyed because I don't understand why that is.
I think it's because of that point that you see not only John and myself here from all the years we've been in, over 20 years in the industry, but all of the other builders and substantial seven-figure income earners, as well as people that have never done network marketing before or just started coming in here. So INFINii is almost like a community where you have the elite of the network marketing industry, and then you have the elite of the e-commerce industry, and then you've got the average folks that are just looking to go ahead and be able to get a substantial plan B going for the first time, and every single community is seeing the opportunity within here. That hasn't happened anywhere before.
Yep. You know, I do want to make one very important point because I don't want to give a wrong impression of where I stand on this. Every single, the people that you call the elite of network marketing, every single one of them that I have met and spoken with, they are extremely caring people. Almost every single one of them has really said repeatedly, their main point has been, I care so deeply about my downlines. Many of them have not seen success before. Before we jump into it, we want to make sure that you are stable, that our downlines will be able to succeed in this, and so on and so on. That's really been their main focus. So I have been very impressed by that. And I mean, you know, the stereotype of the rich MLMer is really there to, you know, move their herds around and make money from that. met. That really doesn't hold water. I have not met any of these big true leaders who behave like that. It's more the small-time online promoters that sometimes act like it. And I'm just being honest about it. I'm sorry if you're a small-time online promoter. I'm not trying to paint you with a white brush, but I kind of am at the same time. So, look, that's just the reality of it, okay? That's just how it plays out. For the people who are big in any industry, they care about their reputation. They care about their reputation, and many of them are daily in contact with the average people in the downline. So they look at the average person in the downline. They have to witness their failure themselves. It's a very shocking thing. That's why I've been really privileged, because I get a lot of emails from people not saying, hey, I failed and I spent all this money with you, what do I do? Largely, 95% of the times that I get emails are people saying, you know, you've changed my life, this has been incredible, thank you for doing this, we are praying for you, we wish you the best, and let us know, we want to keep growing with you. It's a total, and that's, I mean, that's, Kevin can relate with that, Jason can relate with that, John and Ken will begin to relate with that very soon here. That's what is so fulfilling about it. That's what's so incredible. That's what I've seen with a lot of these elite networkers coming in, where there is this very clear understanding. Even if this is not the company where you make the most amount of money as a recruiter, this is the company that will be the most fulfilling for you in terms of the relationships you develop and how your downline gets treated, how you get to witness your downline and your average customer be treated with so much more respect instead of being treated as a money shuffling game. That's what's really cool about it. Anyways, I kind of went on a completely big tangent there, and I did not have any intention of doing it in the beginning. So I will mute myself, and you guys can continue.
Hitesh, that's what we love about you, though.
Yeah, and you know, by the way, I've just got one more thing I'm going to share, Ken. But by the way, you really do have a good radio voice, dude.
Who are you talking
okay.
to, John?
You. okay. Thank you very much for that, because that was, you know, there was not only was there some very, very valuable information in what you shared, but it was shared very effectively, and I for me, I mean, it certainly helped me get more of a sense of the scope and the scale of where this is, and also where this is going. This is really going to be an exciting ride for so many people. We can tell we're getting so many messages from individuals that. That really are exciting. They're excited. They really are starting to see the vision of this truly immense program. So what we want to do is now take that immensity and really dumb things down into a very, very basic three-step building strategy for you, because we've had this request from a lot of you as well. Now, I know, obviously, this is the complete other end of the spectrum, where we talked about very, very successful network marketers, and you're absolutely right, Hitesh. You know, the individuals that have made amazing things happen for themselves in network marketing. It's no different than any professional. Those things don't happen by themselves, and they don't happen overnight. We don't learn when things go well for us. To be quite honest, often we assume we had the answer all along. We learn when we have devastating failures, and so anyone who's doing amazing things in network marketing has had those devastating failures.
Absolutely.
So I'm especially excited for them. But, you know, I'm also equally excited for all of the affiliate network marketers that have never built a dual team before that are asking for this slide that's up right now, the very, very basics. You know, it reminds me of when we were first getting started, and I hope it does for all of you that are long-time network marketers. What I want to share with you is very, very simple. You've probably seen something like this before. I certainly didn't invent it. One of the things that I would really want you to focus on if you're new to building a traditional network marketing business is the line you see on the top on the right-hand side, do first, teach second. So, you know, there are a list of skills that one must acquire to ultimately hit the ambassador family of ranks, and it could be any number of things, from talking to people in the front of a room or talking to people on a telephone or even just picking up that phone. There's a fairly significant list of skills that one needs to acquire. And I can tell you that if there's one particular thing that's on the list that you have an aversion to learning and you try to push that one off to the side, it's going to be shoved back into your face time and time again, not by an individual, but by circumstances. And so you really do need to understand that you have to treat this like a business, have to knuckle down, This will be a very, very easy business to build, but it still requires some effort. It still requires some physical output on your part, more mental than physical. That's for certain. This is not difficult. But you're going to support your team best by learning how and then doing. And so you're not going to be an effective leader if you're asking your small team to do things that you're not prepared to do. So just follow that first line is the best piece of advice you're going to get to begin with. Do first, teach second. So step number one is a build step. It's very straightforward. All it is becoming beginner bonus qualified. That's all it is. And how you do that is up to you. We're going to say that it's going to take you a week to do that, to find two people, customers or partners, to share this with, become beginner bonus qualified, and already start earning from A, faster bonuses, and B, beginner bonus pool. You can do that with a variety of scripts that will be available to you, PDFs available to you, videos available to you. Entirely up to you how you choose to handle that. Next thing you're going to want to do in the next week is shift your focus entirely to the two people you brought into your business. If you play this mentally the way that you need to, you're going to get the results you want. So in other words, in week two, you're going to teach step number one. You did step one, and now you're going to teach step one. Okay? And you're already starting to see that exponential growth that you hear about in network marketing all the time. And that is you're going to help Sue and help Mark become beginner bonus qualified. The only thing that matters to you is Sue and Mark. And that's going to come across to them. And that's going to have an impact on the kind of leader that you become and the way that they look at you and the way they perform for you. And step number three is to make sure that they take on that same leadership role and teach step one after they just finished doing step one. That is it. It doesn't get any simpler than that. You have an exponentially growing business, and believe it or not, if you did nothing other than this, in 8 weeks, you would reach director rank in less than 90 days, and all those bonuses would open for you. If you only sponsored two people, and you taught those steps, and supported those steps for weeks two and three, and made sure that business continued to grow in only 8 weeks, which is only two-thirds of the time that you need, that's only 60 days versus 90 days, you will hit director. You will open all those bonuses to yourself, and your business will be very, very strong moving forward. Ken or anyone else have anything to share in that regard?
No, that's the path right there, John. You hit it perfectly.
So here it is again. You've already got this in the PowerPoint deck. This is exactly the same thing, just showing it in a different way. Hit those bonuses. So we have 90 minutes. I think that we would like to thank you very, very much for your time and attention. Any last words, gentlemen?
No, it's when we get in front of groups like this and we work through, we always have time on our minds, and we like to try and keep it to an hour or less, but there's so much content here, and since we're in the very beginning phases of this being launched, now's the time to have this, you know, type of real conversation back and forth where you can see the, you know, when Hitesh talks about the industry, it's one of the things that attracted me to working with him, and then with Kevin and Jason as well, and then ultimately attracted John the same way, was that there's a realness about the ownership of the company and what they want to achieve. And not only that, they've already achieved it for the last 2+ years with DS domination, which has just absolutely stunned the industry, with doing now over $2.4 billion in sales from their affiliates to the end customers, and having that affiliate base already earned profits nearly $400 million in that short period of time. So imagine what the INFINii model now holds with this level of rewards plan. And so I know, John, you're with me when we say we want to thank both, obviously, Hitesh, Kevin, and Jason for giving us the opportunity to work with them to create this model and to have the type of input we have, so that now there's a bridge between the e-commerce world and the network marketing arena.
I would absolutely like to chime in with you and thank them very much, Ken. I would also like to thank the leaders that are discovering INFINii and are reaching out to us, many of them from the United States, but I'm also we're also talking about Europe and South America, really all over the world. Of course, we've got a fantastic group all throughout Asia, South and North Asia, Australia, fantastic leaders in Australia. And I would really like to thank all of you as well for your patience for this past month, where we've been doing what we need to do to make sure this launch goes off without a hitch. and for the enthusiasm with which you've been starting to share this news.
So I guess as we wrap up here, Kevin, do you or Hitesh want to come on and give us an idea of when we're launching you know, back into the main platform and where we stand?
Yeah. I want to go into something real quick, and then I want to get Hitesh back out here to announce the time. Or if he can't pop out, Hitesh, I can do that as well. But what you guys have here is not only, you know, leaders like John and Ken in this, you know, at the helm of this thing. You also have so many people in the field that are building this in a way that is mind blowing every day. You've got the offline perspective. You have people that are going to teach you how to go ahead and build those lifelong relationships to grow your business. And you know, some of my best friends on the planet are people that I've met on the internet or I've met in network marketing companies. And so cherish those friendships and help them succeed and put your weight and really, really try to help them grow and build, because this is going to be something that for the next 10, 20, 30 years, and even when you're not here anymore, that your kids can take advantage of because of the platform and because of the fact that it's e-commerce. Also, you have an opportunity here when you talk about online strategies and you talk about online marketing. You have an opportunity here that you just do not have in any other company out there. You cannot sell a shake or a skin cream or anything like that. It's very difficult to do in an online setting. It's hard to set up a funnel to sell that. And we have an advantage here. That's why you hear sometimes we talk about people who have put in 100, 200, 300,000, 4,000, 500 people into DS domination. You know, the company underneath it, INFINii, right now. So you have that. You have that ability, and you will be able to live that. But it all starts with reaching out and building those relationships. And now the online stuff, we're going to teach you that. We're going to show you how to do it. But I need you guys to leverage Ken. I need you to leverage John, because these guys know what they're doing. John has grown an income to where he hasn't had to touch a company in decades, and it still pays him an income today. That is the dream. So listen to everybody. Find your path in the system when it comes to marketing, just as you're going to find your path in the system as it comes to which part you're going to earn with on the e-commerce side of the house. Some of you are going to want to sell things from a Shopify account. Some of you are going to want to get on springboards. Some of you are going to run an Amazon business. Some of you are going to run an eBay business. And they're all very easy. Every one of those examples, we have dozens or hundreds of people making job-replacing income right now already doing this. So it's here for you. It's not going anywhere. And it'll be something that'll be in your life for decades to come. So, you know, don't worry that you're not in there and doing it right now, this second, because it's not going anywhere. We're going to be, you know, we're going to partner up for the rest of our lives. When you step foot inside of INFINii, and you know, I'm excited for that. I'm really excited for that. So Hitesh, are you still with us, my friend? Are you still here?
Yep. I'm here. I just was reining myself in and keeping myself in check because strange things happen if I keep talking. So let's go with it. Let's go with the timeline quick. Before I do that, I just want to point out that you can estimate how old John is given the fact that he hasn't touched a company in decades. And so, anyway, I just have to do that. I'm sorry, but let's really quickly talk about our the overall concept here and our release out there. Did you guys already discuss the whole issue with the requests that we received over the last 24 hours to move people around and so on?
No, we haven't, but. Those who
okay. Well, I'll address it very quickly. Look, you have to understand, now that you have gone over the comp plan, hopefully everybody understands that the binary placement, while that is, you know, a fun, great component of this compensation plan, the very significant chunk of your income is actually going to come from your PET side, from the INFINii pay and from your ranking and so on and so forth, right? So you have to start understanding that the binary placement is not the end all of everything. And I've been a little bit concerned having seen, you know, the way people reacted about, oh, you know, can I move people around? Because I don't know if this is the best configuration and that is the best configuration. If the only way for you to succeed with us was for you to get the optimum binary configuration, less than 1% of people would succeed. Okay, that's the statistical reality. So just understand that is not the most important thing in the world. Regardless of your binary placement, you can make a tremendous income as a partner in here. So keeping that in mind, I want to address this. So I specifically said at the Hangout yesterday, if you see an error, if you see something wrong in your binary view, let us know so we can address it. We got tons of requests from people saying, hey, I was wondering, I put this guy four levels deep on the right side, could we move him over here? And we literally cannot do that. That is not a good thing to do. And we start that process, and we are not going to be doing that at all. That is just not fair or correct or ethical to make these kind of adjustments and move people around as if they are, you know, subject matter and we're trying to create molecule models or something. Sorry, I was in the sciences, so you'll hear weird analogies all the time. So what we've done is essentially we have gotten a lock on all the possible errors that were reported. We have fixed pretty much all the errors we came across. There were very few errors overall because we kept shutting down. Anytime we detected some errors popping up, we shut down our pre-launch, which was a very good thing. That's how any responsible company should be running these. So because of that, we had very limited number of errors. We were able to fix pretty much all of them. Very minor things remain at this point, if any. So just understand, if you send a request saying, hey, can you move these people around? That's not going to be honored. That's not going to happen. And that's something that you need to discuss with your upline so they can explain to you why that is not the most critical thing, and they can explain to you using your current placement how to build out a tremendous business on the partner side. Okay, now what we're going to do is we've already shut down all the invites. We're going to freeze everything in the binary side. We've made sure we're going to run a few more tests, and then we're going to open this up tomorrow. We're going to actually open up the cart itself. You're going to have checkouts available, so you'll be all able to go and actually pay and access the training and access the springboards and all that wonderful stuff. All of that will be available to you tomorrow. We're going to start out a very limited version of it at 6 p.m. Eastern. We're going to take the leaders who initially got in. We're going to show them the same we did with the binary structure. We're going to have them come in. They're going to activate their accounts. They can look around, give us some feedback. And then at 9 p.m. Eastern, we're going to open up for everybody, and everybody can get in and start purchasing and start accessing. And you'll be very, very impressed with how much effort was put into getting right to the point and keeping this very relevant to you, because you should be able to finish your initial training within a matter of 2 hours. You should be done with almost all of your initial training. One other thing that I highly recommend you do is tomorrow when we open up, you will find a page in there under foundational training called the game plan. And the game plan is a page that will allow you to decide what your goals are, and it's going to create a game plan for you based on where you are and what your access is. So let's say you're an international person who cannot do Amazon and can do very limited eBay. The game plan is actually going to give you a very specific point-by-point method on, okay, then you will be using Bonanza, you're going to be using this with eBay, and you're going to be doing this on Shopify or WooCommerce, and you're going to build your partner side doing this. It's going to give you a charted out plan for the next 3 months and 6 months and a year. So it's going to walk you through all of those things. So again, when you come in tomorrow and you actually purchase and you get access to all of your trainings and get access to the springboards and everything else that you've been listening about and hearing about, make sure you create a game plan, make sure you follow that game plan, and make sure you treat this like a real business instead of just going off on hype. I mean, we love the hype. I love seeing the comments on Facebook and everything else, but I like a lot more when I see somebody saying, here is what I have done, and here's what I'm going to do in the future. Here is my plan for it. Because that, to me, shows a person who is actually prepared to put their head down, put in some effort, and actually build a real business. So that's what you should be expecting for tomorrow. We are very, very excited, obviously, about it. We have been working literally night and day. Kevin, because he lives in Japan, gets to work only at daytime and gets to claim he works at nighttime as well. So that's awesome for him. The man has not slept properly for a long time. His wife bought him a new coffee machine to help keep him awake. It's incredible. This is all true, by the way. His wife actually bought him a coffee machine so he could actually stay up more. So we've all been Yeah, so we've all been staying up. We've all been working very hard at this. We're very excited because we're hoping that tomorrow is the culmination of a lot of effort and a lot of hard work and a lot of caution about how do we do this the right way and making sure that everybody wins in this. So we're very excited about it. We'll see you guys tomorrow. And I hope all of you enjoyed this and learned a whole lot more. And now, hopefully, you have a very good understanding of how you're going to build yourself up as a partner and build a tremendous business going forward. So from me, it's a very wonderful, great night. Thank you for sticking around for so long. And then John, Ken, Kevin, if you want to just close out, that would be awesome.
I don't think that we could be any more eloquent, so I don't think I'm going to try. But thank you very much for your patience, everybody. So we will see you in a little bit less than 24 hours to get rolling.
Night, everybody. I think we lost Ken, so that's it. All right, I'll see you guys in the system tomorrow.
Wake up, or wake well, depending on where you are.